Hi students, so already relationship between coefficients and zeros explained. Okay, one example also I explained. Okay, now example 3. Find the zeros of the polynomial x square minus 3. Want to find the zeros of x square minus 3, polynomial x square minus 3, and verify the relationship between the zeros and coefficients. Zeros and the coefficients. Okay, so first we need to find the zeros of x square minus 3. Solution. Okay, x square minus 3. If you want to find the zero, your assumption is it is equal to 0. Is equal to 0. Okay, it is quadratic equation, but one x term is missing. X term is missing. Okay, right. X square here minus 3 transposing. Transpose. Okay, minus 3 plus 3. 0 plus 3, 3. 0 plus 3, 3. Okay, then we need x value. Okay. Next, take square root on both sides. Okay. So, x square. Square root of x square is equal to square root of 3. Square root of x square is equal to square root of 3. Okay. Square root of x square value? X. X square means x into x is square root. Okay. So, out of 2 we can take 1. Then, root 3 value we cannot find it. So, you keep the same. Plus or minus root 3. Plus or minus root 3. While taking square root 10, the answers may be plus. Both answers will be plus or both will be minus. Okay. So, x is equal to root 3 and x is equal to minus root 3. Plus root 3 and minus root 3. Plus root 3 and minus root 3. Okay. So, this first root we assume as alpha. The second root assumes beta. Alpha, beta. Okay. Next, we want to verify relationship between zeros and the coefficient. Okay. What's the sum of zeros? Alpha plus beta equal to minus b by a. What is b? Coefficient of x. Coefficient of x. Okay. What is a? Coefficient of x square. Coefficient of x square. Okay. Alpha plus root 3. Alpha plus root 3. Beta minus root 3. Okay. So root 3 plus of minus root 3. Okay. Plus of minus root 3. What is a polynomial? X square minus 3. X square minus 3. Where is x term? Any x term is there? No. Okay. So coefficient of x is 0. Coefficient of x is 0. So, b value 0. 0 by anything? 0. Minus 0 by 1. Minus 0 by 1. Okay. Right. Plus root 3 minus root 3. Plus root 3 minus root 3 0. Okay. Then 0 by 1? 0. 0 by 1? 0. Okay. 0 is neither negative nor positive. Okay. So, don't assume as negative. Okay. 0. Next, product of zeros, alpha beta, is equal to c by a. What is c? Constant term. A, coefficient of x square. Alpha already we found it. Okay. Plus root 3, beta minus root 3. So, root 3 into minus root 3. Root 3 into minus root 3. What is constant term here? It is constant term. Minus 3. What is constant term? Minus 3. So, minus 3 by a. What is a? Coefficient of x square. Coefficient of x square? 1. Coefficient of x square? 1. Minus 3 by 1. Plus into plus? Minus. Plus into minus? Minus. Root 3 into root 3? 3. So, minus root 3, minus root 3. So, verify. Relationship between zeros and the coefficients? Verified. Okay, that's all. Thank you. Next question, example 4. Find your quadratic polynomial the sum and product of whose zeros are minus 3 and 2 respectively. Okay, we want to make one quadratic polynomial using these two values. These two values are, one is sum of zeros, another one product of zeros. Okay, first one you write it, given solution, two zeros are given, alpha plus beta, sum of zeros minus 3, sum and product of zeros, alpha plus beta 2, alpha plus beta 2. Okay, using these two values we want to make one quadratic polynomial. Okay, right. Quadratic polynomial standard format, k x square minus of alpha plus beta x plus alpha beta plus alpha beta. Okay, it is a standard form while making quadratic polynomial. Okay, right. K, any constant, k means constant. Okay, right. X square minus alpha plus beta value minus 3. So minus 3. Already this minus is noted. Okay. The alpha plus beta value minus 3. X plus alpha beta value 2. Alpha beta value 2. So k into x square minus into minus plus 3x 2. Okay. So polynomial x square plus 3x plus 2. It is a recurve polynomial. Okay, once again repeat. Here given sum and product of zeros given. Sum of zeros minus 3. Product of zeros alpha plus alpha beta 2. Okay. So format k into x square minus alpha plus beta x plus alpha beta. K constant. Okay. Constant. Okay. Here there is no constant. So you leave the k. So x square plus 3x plus 2. X square plus 3x plus 2. Exercise 2.2. First question. Okay, already two exam results explained. Okay, related to this problem. Find the zeros of the following quadratic polynomials and verify the relationship between the zeros. Between the zeros and the coefficient. Okay, right. First you want to find the zeros of this given polynomial. Then we will prove that, verify it. Okay, right. Solution. X square minus 2x minus 8. Okay, it is given polynomial, assume is equal to 0. Why? Because we want to find the zeros of this polynomial. Okay, right. You check it, any coefficient of x square? No. Okay, only one. Okay, so leave it. Now you take the constant. What is constant? Minus 8. Minus 8. Okay. So write the possibilities of product of any two numbers. Answer will be 8. What are the possibilities? 1 8 is 8. 1 8 is 8. 2 4s are 8. 2 4s are 8. 4 2s are 8. 8 1 is 8. That's all. Only two possible. Okay, right. Here minus. Here minus. Okay. So difference of these two numbers we need as 2. Difference of these two numbers we need as 2. What is the difference of 1 and 8? 7. Difference of 2 and 4? 2. Difference of 2 and 4? 2. Okay, you select this one. 2, 4. Okay. Listen. You want to check it. 2, 4 are 8. But we need minus 8. We need minus 8. So out of these two zeros, either 2 or 4, any one is negative. Okay, right. Here what is this? Minus. So largest number negative. Largest number negative. Here minus, so largest number negative. Anyway, now one second check it. That's it, the minus? Minus. 2 4s are 8. Correct. Minus 8. 2 minus 4? 2 minus 4? Minus 2. Yes, correct. Okay. Right. X plus 2 into x minus 4 equal to 0. X plus 2 into x minus 4 is equal to 0. So x plus 2 is equal to 0, or x minus 4 is equal to 0. Maybe both are 0, or either any one 0. Okay, we assume both are 0. So x is equal to minus 2. X is equal to minus 2 plus 2 minus 2, and x is equal to 4. Minus 4 plus 4. Minus 4 plus 4. So now we found two zeros. One is alpha minus 2. Another one is beta 4. Another one is 4. Okay. Then you want to verify relationship between zeros and a coefficient. Okay. Sum of zeros. Sum of zeros, alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. What is b? Coefficient of x. Coefficient of x. Okay, what is coefficient of x? Minus 2. Coefficient of x, minus 2. Listen carefully. Already one minus is there. You write a minus. Then what is b value? Minus 2. You write one more minus. Are you clear? This minus you keep it as same. B value negative. So minus 2 divided by, what is a? Coefficient of x square. Coefficient of x square, what is that? 1. Here alpha. Alpha is equal to minus 2. Beta is equal to 4. Alpha is equal to minus 2. Beta is equal to 4. Beta is equal to 4. Okay. Then you check it. Minus 2 plus 4, 2. Minus 2 plus 4, 2. Minus into minus bracket. Bracket in axis of symbol, minus of minus 2. So multiplication here. Minus into minus plus 2. 2 by 1, 2. Okay. So sum of zeros verified. Sum of zeros verified. Next to product of zeros, alpha beta is equal to c by a. Alpha beta c by a. Okay, product of zeros. Okay, what are the zeros? Minus 2 and 4. So minus 2 into 4. Minus 2 into 4, it is equal to c. C constant term. Okay, what is constant term? Minus a. Minus a. Divided by a. A value 1. Minus into minus plus. Minus into plus. Minus. 2 fours are a. Minus a. Minus a. Here also minus a. So verified. Answer verified. Okay, 2 zeros minus 2 and a 4. Okay, that's all. Okay, 4s square minus 4s plus 1. Okay, same. You want to find the zeros of the polynomial and verify the relationship between zeros and the coefficient. Okay, so we assume it is equal to 0. 4s square minus 4s plus 1 is equal to 0. Okay, now you check it. Any coefficient of s square? Yes, 4. So this coefficient we want to multiply with the constant term. We want to multiply with the constant term. 1, 4 is 4. Okay, next thing you select two numbers. Okay, then product of the two numbers, we need 4. We need 4. You select two numbers. 1, 4 is 4. 2, 2 are 4. Any other possibilities? No. Okay, right. Here positive. So we want to add these two numbers. 1 plus 4, 5. But here we need 4. Here we have 4. So we need 4. 2 plus 2, 4. So you select 2 and 2. This one no need. Okay, 2. 2. 2. 2. Okay, the next one. 2 into 2, 4. Correct. But 2 plus 2, 4. But we have here minus 4. We have here minus 4. Here positive. Either 2 zeros are positive. Sorry, 2 roots are positive or 2 are negative. So both are negative. Now you check it. Minus into minus plus. 2, 2 are 4. Minus 2, minus 2, minus 4. Minus 2, minus 2, minus 4. Okay. Here, this coefficient multiply with the constant term. This coefficient multiply with the constant term. Okay. So reverse. Divide. We want to divide by 4. We want to divide by 4. We want to divide by 4. Okay. Now ready? Yes. Minus. Yes. Minus. 2 by 4. Then yes. Minus 2 by 4. Equal to 0. Equal to 0. Okay, are you clear? S minus 2 by 4, S minus 2 by 4. Okay, you want to simplify here or you find the step? Okay, wherever possible you can do it. Otherwise, in last step do it. So s minus 2 by 4 equal to 0. S minus 2 by 4. S minus 2 by 4 equal to 0. S minus 2 by 4 is equal to 0. Okay, then s is equal to 2 by 4. Then s is equal to 2 by 4. 2 by 4. Okay, s is equal to 2 by 4. S is equal to 2 by 4. Then we can reduce s is equal to 1, 2 is 2, 2, 2 are 4. 1 by 2. 1 by 2. Okay. Okay. Now, s is equal to 1 by 2. Then s is equal to 1 by 2. So, alpha 1 by 2, beta 1 by 2. Okay. Now, polynomial 4s square minus 4s plus 1. Now, you want to write ABC value. A is coefficient of square term, x square term. Here instead of x, use s. So a square coefficient of s square. Coefficient of s square 4. Coefficient of s minus 4. Coefficient of s minus 4. Then constant 1. Constant 1. Okay, now verify alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. Alpha, beta, it is equal to minus b by a. Alpha value 1 by 2, beta value 1 by 2. Alpha value 1 by 2, beta value 1 by 2. Then minus b value minus 4. Minus of minus 4. Okay, this minus formula, this minus a in b value minus 4. Okay, divided by 1. Divided by 1. Okay, right. Sorry, a value 4. A value 4. Coefficient b by a value 4. A value 4. Then 1 by 2, 1 by 2. What is mean by 1 by 2? Half. 1 by 2 means half. So half plus half 1. Okay, always keep the same denominator 2. 1 plus 1, 2. 2 by 2, 1. Minus it, otherwise you write it. 1 plus 1 divided by 2. Okay, minus and minus plus. So 4 by 4. 4 by 4. 1 plus 1, 2. 2 by 2, 1. 2 by 2, 1. 4 by 4, 1. 4 by 4, 1. Next to alpha beta. Product of zeros. Product of zeros. C by A. C by A. Product of zeros. C by A. Product of zeros. C by A. Okay. Alpha value 1 by 2. Beta value 1 by 2. This is equal to C value 1. A value 4. A value 4. Okay. Product of fractions. Product of numerators, divided by product of denominators, product of denominators. So 1 into 1, 1, 2, 2 are 4, is equal to 1 by 4. So 1 by 4, 1 by 4, verified. 1 by 4, 1 by 4, verified. Okay, that's all. Okay. Next question, same, find the zeros of the quadratic polynomial and verify the relationship between zeros and the coefficient. Okay. There are only two terms are there. One is u square term, another one is u term. Constant term missing. Okay. Alright. Solution. 4u square plus 8u. It is equal to 0. 4u square plus 8u. It is equal to 0. Okay. Right. We cannot factorize it. Okay. Then whatever common term, you take it as. What are the common? 4, 4. Then u square is here u. So u is common. Remaining 4 you already take it as remaining u. Here 8, 4 2 are 8. 4 already you take it. Remaining 2. U already you take it. That's all. Equal to 0. So before u into u plus 2 is equal to 0. So before u is equal to 0, then u plus 2 is equal to 0. U plus 2 is equal to 0. Here multiply by 4, divide by 4. Multiply by 4, divide by 4. So u is equal to 0 by 4. So u is equal to 0. U equal to 0. Then here plus 2 minus 2. So u is equal to minus 2. U is equal to minus 2. Okay. So two zeros are there. One is alpha 0, another one is beta 0. Okay. Right. So 4 u square plus 8u. 4u square plus 8u. Okay. Here what is a value? 4. A value 4. B value यही कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ यू, कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ यू स्क्वायर, ओके सी कांस्टेंट जीरो, कांस्टेंट जीरो, ओके यू वांट टू वेरीफाई रिलेशन बिटवीन जीरोस एंड देयर कोएफिशिएंट, ओके देन अल्फा प्लस बीटा इज इक्वल टू माइनस बी बाई ए, माइनस बी बाई ए, व्हाट इज अल्फा, 10 is 0 and 10 minus 2. 10 0 and 10 minus 2. So alpha 0, beta minus 2. Okay, here minus, first you write it. Next you write the b value. B value 8. B value 8. 8 divided by a value 4. 8 by 4. Plus 0 plus minus 2, minus 2 only. 1 4 is 4, 2 4 are 8. 1 4 is 4, 2 4 are 8. Minus 2. So sum of zeros verified. Next product of zeros, alpha beta. Alpha beta. Alpha beta is equal to c by a, constant divided by coefficient of x square. Alpha 0, 0 into minus 2. Constant same 0. 0 by a value 4. Okay, 0 and anything 0. 0 by 4, 0. 0 by 4, 0. So verified. Relationship between zeros and a coefficients verified. Okay. From first sum, remaining sums homework. Okay. Here three sums explained. In example two sums, totally five sums explained from this one method. Okay. Remaining sums homework. Okay. Then next second sum. Next second sum. Okay. Second question. Find a quadratic polynomial each with the given numbers as the sum and product of its zeros. Okay. Here sum of zeros and product of zeros given. Okay. So 1 by 4. Alpha plus beta is equal to 1 by 4. Alpha plus beta is equal to 1 by 4. Product of zeros alpha beta is equal to minus 1. Product of zeros alpha beta is equal to minus 1. Okay. Format. Standard format. K into x square minus of alpha plus beta x plus alpha beta. Alpha beta. Okay, general format. Okay, product of zeros and sum of zeros given. Na? This is general form. Okay, k. K into x square. What is alpha plus beta value? 1 by 4. So minus 1 by 4. Minus 1 by 4. Okay, x. Plus alpha beta value minus 1. Alpha beta value minus 1. Okay, now. Okay, denominator 4. Other denominators are 1. So we want to multiply with 4. We want to multiply with 4. Okay, multiply by 4. So 4x square. If multiply by 4, this 4 cancel. So x plus into minus minus 4. We want to multiply by 4. We want to multiply by 4 by all the term. That is k. That is k. Here k value is 4. K value is 4. Okay. So 4x square minus x minus 4. Minus x minus 4. Okay, that's all. Alpha plus beta is equal to root 2. Alpha plus beta is equal to root 2. Alpha beta is equal to 1 by 3. Alpha beta is equal to 1 by 3. Okay, then general form k into x square minus alpha plus beta x plus alpha beta. Alpha beta. Now substitute. K into x square minus alpha plus beta value root 2. Root 2 x plus alpha beta value 1 by 3. 1 by 3. Okay, here denominator 3. So we want to multiply by 3 to all the terms. All the terms. Okay. So 3x square minus 3 root 2 x plus 1. Multiply by 3 and 3 by 3 cancel. 3 by 3 cancel. So 3x square minus 3 root 2 x plus 1. Okay, that's all. Next, here alpha plus beta value 0. Alpha plus beta value 0. Alpha beta is equal to root 5. Alpha beta is equal to root 5. Okay, now ready? K into x square minus alpha plus beta x plus alpha beta. Alpha beta. Okay, ready? K x square alpha plus beta value 0. So 0 into x is 0. So 0 x. Plus alpha beta value root 5. Alpha beta value root 5. Okay. So that's all. No denominator. So no need to multiply by any number. So that's all. X square plus root 5. X square plus root 5. Okay. So this exercise over. Remaining three sums homework. Remaining three sums homework. Okay. Thank you. That's all.